2-hour time estimate y'all gave.
Or is it a couple hours to that?
Yeah, well, it was.
Are you sure, your testimony you got to give in that state was Nydia Tisdale's truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Yeah. Have a seat, please, ma'am. Come up forward and introduce yourself to the court, please.
I'm Kathy Burt.
All right, Ms. Burt. Are you employed? Do you work for a living?
I do.
What do you do for a living?
Co-owner of Burt's Farm.
All right, what's Burt's Farm?
It's where we grow all fall stuff.
I'm sorry, Ms. Burt. You're very soft spoken.
Okay.
Yeah, can I get it? Behind us.
This one?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Carry?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, let's go back to what is Burt's Farm, please.
We grow fall vegetables, pumpkins, Indian corn, all the fall decorations.
Is it a working farm?
It is.
You said your co-owner, who owns it with you?
My husband, Johnny.
Does the state of Georgia have any involvement in your farm?
No.
How long has that farm been your family, Greg?
Started growing pumpkins as a roadside stand. 1972, I guess. It's been a long time. 72.
Now, I want to direct your attention to August 23rd, 2014. Did y'all hold a rally at the farm?
We did.
Do you remember who organized that rally with y'all?
Clint Berger.
Okay. Now, when did you learn there was going to be a rally? You remember that?
They called, I guess, a week or so, maybe. I'm not really specific when it was, maybe a week or two before.
Okay.
Not a long time.
Did the Republican Party pay you? Did you use your performance venue?
No.
Were y'all even open for the things that you just talked about, selling the pumpkins and squash and stuff like that yet?
No.
On the day of the rally, did you have any duties? What were you doing there?
Well, hosting it, I guess you would say. I was, as people come in, and I greeted them, welcomed them.
Right. At some point, did you encounter the defendant in this case?
I did.
All right. Where did you encounter her at?
She was outside the parking, well, in the very front of the barn, just coming in.
All right. Now, did you speak with her?
I do.
You remember the conversation?
Yes, I do.
All right. What went on there? What did she say?
Well, she come in and I invited her, you know, welcomed her, and told her, you know, that she was welcome. We had pumpkin pie, pumpkin rolls, anything, you know, as I told everybody else. And she told me that she was there to film for the governor.
Okay. She was there to film for the governor.
Mm-hmm.
You sure that's what she said?
I'm sure. Positive.
Okay. Was she wearing anything, any lanyards, any IDs, anything like that?
No.
Did she tell you she was a citizen journalist? You
no.
That? Okay, so she tells you that. Do y'all continue to converse?
Small talk, and then she went on and off and mingled with everybody else.
Okay. Now, did she ever ask you could she come?
No. She told me, basically, she just told me what she was going to do, that she was there with him for the governor. I didn't question it because I thought she was there for the governor at his request.
No. At some point during the rally, did you learn that was not true?
I did.
All right. Now, did you observe where she was sitting?
Yes, I did.
Where was the defendant sitting?
She was sitting on the left across from us at the front, very front. If you want to call it a front row.
Where, what did you call the area where the speaking was taking place? Did it have a name?
Not to my knowledge. Just a place where they just got up and talked.
Okay. And do you remember when you learned, or that she was not willing to go? You recall where you were?
Yes, I was sitting on the right side, maybe three or four rows down. I'm not sure exactly how far it was. And Clint Bearden and one of the governor's aides come over to us.
And was there a conversation about specifically about the defendant and felony?
Yes, there was. They told us that the governor was uncomfortable.
What they told us. That's what she believed, the governor was uncomfortable or not.
If it's going to go to explain some behavior.
It is, what she's about to do. Plus, Ms. Bearden already just testified. It was not your say, what he said. What did he say?
That the governor was uncomfortable with her feminine and we were the property owners and we asked her to quit.
Okay, and what happened after that conversation? Did y'all ask them to have her quit?
Yes, Tony Wooten went up and asked her to quit feminine. Well, I think as well as Clint Beard, and I think
well,
they went on
me, but this is outside for here.
Only what's in her personal.
Well, I asked, did people go and ask her?
Yes.
Okay, what's our first question?
She doesn't object to that. She doesn't know what they asked. She doesn't know what they said.
What did she see happen?
That's a better question. What did you see happen after y'all had this conversation about her stopping filming?
Clint Baird, I think him and they went over and asked her to quit filming. And she was not.
So she thinks they did.
No, they went over and asked.
Well, you can only testify to what was said if you heard.
Well, now, I did not hear them go over and ask her. But I know what they asked us.
Okay, and then let's see what happened. What did you see after that? Did Clint go over there?
They went over and I guess they asked her to quit filming.
Well, again. I'm sorry.
Now, what you guess? Now, what you guess?
Okay, they went over and asked her to quit feminine, and she would not.
Ms. Burt.
Can I?
If you didn't hear what they said, do you just say what he's asking you what you saw, not what you heard?
Okay, they went over to her.
Okay, there we go. There we go. All right. Now, what did you see after they went over to do whatever they did in this?
She refused.
Well,
she would. Well,
that's not what you saw. Let me object to that, please. That's again a hearsay statement. It's not what you saw. I'm not responsive as well.
Did you see?
I'll sustain that if that's saying something that was heard. But if she did hear it, she'd say what she heard.
I did not hear it. What I saw, and I thought that's what you asked me, is what I saw.
Okay, what did you see? What did you see?
I saw her tell no or shake her head and start kind of throwing a temper tantrum.
All right. Now, who was there when you saw this? Who was standing by her? Was anyone standing? Was he seeing what? You see what I'm getting at, Ms. Burt? Describe what you saw as far as what was going on with Mr. Beard. Start there.
Okay, Mr. Bearden went over, I think, and asked her. I'm sure he went over and he asked her, and she would not comply with him. And then Tom Wooten went over and asked her.
Excuse me. Let's talk about what you, maybe not what was said, but what the behavior you saw, the actions, the responses. You make the assumptions you want in your head, but you understand what I'm saying?
I understand.
The actions that you saw. Let's start. Did Mr. Beard go over and speak with him?
He did.
Now, where was Mr. Wooten at this time, do you remember?
Standing up front.
Okay, now, what did you see the actions of when Mr. Beardmore spoke with him? What actions did you observe from where you were sitting?
Just her frailing around, saying, you know, I didn't hear, but just her frailing around.
Okay, when you say frailing, what do you mean, describe that with her occurring down on Mr. Beardmore?
No.
Okay.
Shake of the head, no.
Okay. Now, at some point, does Captain Wooten go over there?
Yes.
All right, now again, what you observed in the actions of the persons, what you saw there, what did you see?
I saw him go over and approach her.
All right, did they appear, did you see where he was standing in relation to her?
He was standing in front of her.
All right, at some point, did it appear as though they were having a conversation?
Yes.
Do you recall how long they spoke?
Just a few seconds.
All right, what did you see after you went over and began to speak with her?
I saw her again, frailing around, saying, shaking, and just, really just throwing a tantrum.
What does it mean, throwing a tantrum? Let's flesh that out, okay?
Well, she was violently, you know, twisting back and forth and saying no.
Okay.
Or shaking her head, that's the impression I got, was no.
At some point, did you see Captain Wooten put his hands on her or grab her?
I saw him, just help her to get up and take her over to the, over to try to get her to leave. She was asked to leave.
Okay, now?
She didn't have to, all she had to do is put her camera down. She wasn't, nobody made her leave.
Not responsive, and it's...
All right, let me ask you this. We left off with him helping her up.
Mm-hmm.
What you said, you know. Did you observe the defendant leaving the area?
Yes.
Okay, describe that. What did you see as her and Captain Wooten left the area?
I saw her fighting and him trying to escort her out and her fighting him.
Did you see her swinging?
They had got over past me. I did not see that, but I did see her refusing to go. I saw the scuffle.
Were you present in the barn area when she was being detained?
Not. I did go in there when she kept hollering. I did go in there.
What was she hollering, you remember?
Kathy Burt gave me permission to be here.
So how long have you been in the barn area?
I went and talked to her, and just for a few minutes, because I went and talked to her, and I told her that she misrepresented herself when she come in, that she told me she was there for the governor. And she didn't she didn't deny that.
Okay, so how long did you talk to her? I guess I'm trying to figure out how long you've been there.
Maybe 5 minutes.
Now, did you leave the barn area?
I went back out and sat back down.
Do you remember who all was in the barn when you left?
My daughter was.
Okay. Now, where was the defendant? Where was she at when you left her?
Leaning over the table or the checkout counter is what we call it.
Right. And where was Captain Wooten?
Standing to the side of her, restraining her.
He wasn't directly behind her?
No.
Did you see you had a camera?
She did.
Did you see anybody touching the camera or doing anything with the camera?
No.
No. Did anyone else approaching Ms. Burt and ask for permission to record or tell you that they were recording besides Ms. Tisdale?
No.
man named Brian Pritchard, does that ring a bell?
No.
Good afternoon, Matt, how are you?
I'm fine.
Would it be fair to say that you don't like this decision?
No, it would not be fair to say that.
So, you...
I don't dislike anybody.
And you harbor no animosity towards him?
No, I don't harbor any animosity. I hate the whole incident that happened, but I harbor no animosity. I kind of feel sorry for him.
And you understood, as I did, that you had agreed to hold a public rally at your place, right?
We did. It was many of several that we have done.
Several both at your place and for its pumpkin farm. And at other locations, you were a host, correct?
Just at the farm.
All right. So you had other political rallies there, correct? And those rallies, like this one, I'm just using the word rally, were open to the public, correct?
They were open to the public as far as, you know, anybody in the county that are our neighbors and friends, yes.
So, are you saying that it was some public limitation on who could appear?
We didn't put any public limitation. I don't know if the Republican Party did or not.
Did you know that Governor Deal had advertised the rally on the internet?
I did not.
Did you know whether or not there was any limitation on who could come?
No.
Or what they could do?
No.
Did you know, and that's, I'm referring to Defendant's Exhibit Number 3, did you know that there were public advertisements, for example, taken in the Delano Nugget about the rally?
I did not.
And did you know whether or not there are any limitations in that public advertisement?
No.
Did you know that there was a advertisement under PNG Defendant's Exhibit Number 4, if you take a look at that, in which the advertisement and the public was invited to come. The event is free and all are welcomed and invited to attend. Was that your understanding?
Not really, no. They just set it up and we've always, you know, done that and they take care of all that.
Okay.
We just furnish the place, more or less.
Okay, and when you say they, you're talking about the Republican Party?
Yes.
Okay, so if the Republican, did they pay you anything?
No.
Did you have any official relationship with the Republican Party?
No.
And would it be fair to say that the Republican Party was kind of deciding who was going to be there, who was going to speak, kind of what was going on, and you were just providing the location? Is that
yes,
fair?
Yes, okay. That's fair.
All right. you did not have any understanding, did you, from the Republican Party that anybody was barred from coming back, was prohibited from coming?
No.
Okay. And you didn't provide you, the Burts, because it's your place.
Yes.
Didn't provide any public information to say we're limiting this to anybody or we're not allowing certain people in.
Correct. We left that up to the Republican Party.
Sure. And in fact, as I understand it, there was no, you're not aware of any limitation.
reputation and any, and any social media presence, any advertising presence, or any other location, you're unaware that, that certain people were not welcome, correct?
Well, I do know that the, you know, as far as Democrats, and, you know, they, although they were welcome, but they were not supposed to be able to take pictures and do all that. They did ask some of them to leave, in fact.
But I'm asking you about the public. The event is free and all are welcome and invited to attend, correct?
It's in there, but we didn't put it in there.
Well, you didn't put in anything other than that anywhere, correct?
We did not do anything like that.
Okay, and the Republican Party, you know, there were some, like yard signs for some of the candidates out front of the location that you went in for the rally. Do you remember that?
They were, yes.
Okay. And you also had some signs on the barn that were affixed to the barn out there. I'm using the word barn, right?
I think, yes, it was Governor Deal's, some of his signs, I think.
Okay, but I mean, you, the Burt's Farm had some signs out there as well. Over the barn, it announced, I'm going to hand you as marked as defendant's exhibit A. It announced Burt's Farm, right?
You're kind of losing me. What are you saying?
There were signs that you all had on the building. You, Burt's Farms, had on the building.
Our own signs?
Yes.
Which is Burt's Farm?
Yes. That's what I'm talking
there
about.
There now, yes.
Yeah. And I'm going to hand you what's been marked as Exhibit 9, okay? And there were campaign signs that were placed there. Also, your Burt's Farm signs were also affixed. They were tacked up. They were on the barn, right?
Yes.
Okay. And I guess my point is that prior to the rally, neither yourself nor anybody from the Republican Party or Burt's Farms had any limitation posted about who couldn't come or who could come.
I couldn't tell you for sure. I did not. I see the signs, but as far as them posting or me knowing it beforehand, I did not.
Okay, did you know it on that day?
No.
Did you see any signs posted that said, No Democrats and no filming?
No.
Okay. Because you could have put signs up, or the Republican Party could have put up signs.
They
would have done that with your permission, right? But they didn't. You didn't see any of those signs, right?
No.
Okay. Well, you know, when you told us a little bit about you, as I understood, you were just hosting the event. You felt yourself to be the host.
Right.
Right. And you were welcoming people when they came in. You were right inside and to the right.
Right.
Do you recall when now Senator Perdue, and it was Candidate Perdue, do you recall when he came in?
No, I don't. He may have been late. It seems like he was. But I don't recall.
Well, there were a number of people that were coming in and out, correct?
Yes.
And you were having conversations with a number of people, correct?
Right.
And you were greeting a number of people, correct? And you understood that it wasn't necessarily just a rally for Governor Deal anymore, but there were going to be a bunch of other potential candidates and they were going to speak, correct?
That is correct, but it did not know that until the day before.
Okay. Well, I guess
Would it be fair to say that you were letting the Republican Party kind of call the show?
Yes.
Let me hand you what's been marked as defendant's exhibit number 10 and defendant's exhibit number 11. Do you recognize those photographs? Do you? I need mine.
Yes, I do. I don't have my pocketbook, sorry.
You need just reading glasses? Mm-hmm. Want to try these?
Yeah.
Is that any good? I guess we're both equally blind. Now that's on I'm going to ask a question while you're looking, okay? That's on the, as you go in, that's on the right-hand side, right? And that's where you were greeting all the folks that were coming in. If you're coming in from the outside, coming in from the outside, you're on the right, correct? And, for example, when the candidates came in, do you see any of the candidates right there?
Honestly, I am not that familiar with all of them. Had never seen any of them, a lot of them, until they come in that day.
Okay. Do you see your husband there?
Yes, I do.
Do you see him talking with the tall gentleman?
Mm-hmm.
Would you disagree, or have any reason to disagree that that's Mr. Perdue, or now Senator Perdue?
I won't disagree, but I can't say for sure that it is either.
Have you had an opportunity to look at the video?
No.
Did you see right behind Senator Perdue was Ms. Tisdale, who was filming this, and these are stills from the video. And she was filming it, holding the camera right there.
No, I didn't even really notice it, even then.
Okay. So she was maybe 5 feet from you when she was filming the candidate. And while the candidate had talked to you and then talked to your husband. Okay. Now, had you talked to Ms. Tisdale prior to that?
Yes.
And where did you talk to her prior to that?
As she come in on the right side of the barn, as she come in.
Okay. So before she was filming Senator Perdue right there when he came in, you had talked with her, correct?
Yes.
And that's the conversation. Well, who else was there during this conversation?
My daughter was.
And how long before that, before Senator Perdue came in, was that conversation? Did that conversation occur?
I couldn't tell you.
Okay. Did Ms. Tisdale tell you her name?
She probably did tell me her name, and I told her mine, but, you know, as far as...
The way you ordinarily host an event is you say, hi, Ms. Burt, this is my place, welcome, or something to that effect.
Right.
Is that the way you would do it?
Well, anybody that come in, I just told them who I was, and they probably told me who they were, because, you know, that's... Like you said, that's general.
And there's a lot of people, and you don't really, you're going through those motions, and you say things that it's hard to remember sometime down the road, correct?
That can happen.
Sure.
Sure it can.
Okay. Well, who was the person you greeted before Ms. Tisdale?
I have no idea.
And who was the person you greeted after?
I have no idea.
And do you know how long the conversation was with the person you greeted before him?
No.
Or the person that you greeted afterwards?
I think she was the last person in, to be honest. I don't remember anybody else coming in. There could have been, but I think she was the last one. She was a little late.
She was a little late. Was Governor Deal even there at that time, do you know?
Yes.
He was already there? Was Attorney General Owens already there, to your recollection?
I think everybody was there, but she was the last one to come in, okay, as far as when I was standing there.
When you were standing there and had this conversation, generally speaking, she would tell you her name, correct?
Right.
Did that ring any bell with you at all?
Not at all.
So you had no reason to suspect that the Republican Party wouldn't want her present?
No.
Nobody had said a word to you prior to that with regard to who she was and what she was doing or anything, right?
No, except her, because she did tell me that she was there with him for the governor.
Okay, okay.
And I thought she was solely with him.
Here's my question.
Okay.
And perhaps you can listen to my question and answer my question. If you need to explain your answer, you can. Here's my question. Had anybody prior to that time told you anything about her?
No.
And you didn't know her, correct?
No.
And she had a camera bag with her, correct?
She was videoing when she walked in. She was videoing the
okay.
sign. And I couldn't tell you. When I'm in these things, I'm always very nervous. I don't take all this stuff in.
Okay. And there was a conversation about welcome, have some pumpkin pie. We've got pumpkin pie and some other of those goodies that y'all specialize in, right?
Yes.
Okay. So it was a pleasant conversation.
It was.
Correct. Do you recall whether she told you that she had videotaped of the governor before?
No, all she said was, I'm here to video for the governor. Again, I thought that it was a done deal. He had hired her to do that.
Had she told you, did she tell you that she had videotaped the governor before?
She did tell me she had some of the events, some things before.
Okay. How many events did she tell you about?
She didn't say.
Did she tell you that she had videoed other political events before?
No, she didn't. We didn't talk about anything like that. She just told me that. We kind of small talked, and she went her way, and I went mine.
So she did not tell you that she was going to put the video on YouTube?
No.
And she did not tell you that she had put a number of videos on YouTube?
No.
And she did not tell you that she had videoed other political events?
No.
And that she was there to video the entire political event? She didn't tell you any of those things?
No.
So the only thing that she, the only thing, the one line she said to you was, I'm here to video for the governor.
Yes.
That's it. That's the one line
that's,
you remember.
That's all I remember.
Okay. Did she ask you about the bathroom?
She could have, but if she did, I don't remember.
Okay. So there could be parts of the conversation that you don't remember. And you don't remember exactly what was said. There was a press of people. There are a number of people. You had talked to a bunch of people before. You talked to some people afterwards. So you don't know exactly what the conversation was.
Yes, I do know what she told me about.
That one line. Okay. She went into the event.
Yes.
After she came by you, and she went right up front, correct?
I guess I really didn't pay no attention to her anymore after she went in. I had no reason to be suspicious of her. She told me she was there for the governor. Governor, in my mind, that was a done deal. He had hired or asked her to come,
Hold
and
on.
I looked at nothing
Did you
else.
Ask her, are you with the governor?
No.
Did, did she have any?
She told me she was with the governor.
Did she have any Governor Deal stickers or pins or anything like that?
No.
Did she have anything to indicate that she was affiliated with any candidate or any party?
No.
Okay. And I guess my question was that she went in and went to the front, correct?
Again, I don't know. I did not watch her.
You did not see her sitting?
I did not.
Hold on. Let me finish my question, please. You didn't see her sitting on the front row?
I saw her on the front row, but I did watch her after we talked and she started mingling around, but yes, I did see her there.
Okay. And she was sitting on the front row, correct?
Right.
And she was sitting on the front row holding her camera, correct?
Yes.
And she was sitting on the front row holding her camera and recording Clint Bearden when he started introducing the folks, correct?
I'm sure she was. I was still in the barn getting everything ready, and then I went on out there, so I'm sure. I mean, I guess she did. I couldn't tell you sure on that.
Okay. You don't remember anything about posting it on YouTube?
No.
Did you tell her in any sense that she couldn't come in and film?
I did not. I thought she was with the governor, and that was nothing.
So the answer is no.
No.
Do you recall how many candidates had spoken before anybody went to talk to Ms. Tisdale?
No.
I understand that you saw Mr. Bearden go talk to Ms. Tisdale, correct? Where was Mr. Bearden sitting?
He was standing. I think he was standing. I'll be honest, I really don't know.
Okay. Do you know Mr. Pritchett?
No.
Did you see anybody else taking pictures or recording?
No.
Did you see anybody else holding up a cell phone and recording or taking pictures with a camera?
No.
Okay. Did anybody mention to you anybody else that was taking pictures?
No.
Did, after you saw Mr. Bearden go talk with Ms. Tisdale, how long was that conversation?
I'm not sure.
Did Mr. Bearden come back?
Yes.
Right. He did not sit there. He came back, correct?
Yes.
And did he talk with Officer Wooten?
He came over to us.
So did he talk with Officer Wooten?
I'm not sure.
At that time?
I'm not sure.
He came to talk with you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he wasn't hired by Burt's Farms.
No.
He wasn't in any way a employee or otherwise of Burt's Farms, correct?
No.
Okay. And then did Mr. Bearden go talk with Mr. Wooten?
Yes.
And then did both of them go back to where Ms. Tisdale was?
I'm not sure.
Okay. Do you recall after that whether Officer Wooten went to talk with Ms. Tisdale?
I know he went and talked with her.
Okay. And where was Mr. Bearden, if you recall?
I don't remember.
Okay. As I understood what you said, you saw Mr. Wooten standing in front of Ms. Tisdale.
He stood in front of her after Clint and this other guy went over and asked her to leave. Then Johnny.
I didn't ask you that question. Listen to me, if you would. Did you see Deputy Wooten standing in front of Ms. Tisdale?
When he was asked to.
Okay.
So
the answer is yes.
Ask her to leave.
Which you didn't hear. You want to just keep volunteering answers to the questions that I haven't asked? Is that the way you show your ability to answer questions? Did you see him standing in front of Ms. Tisdale?
Yes.
And the camera would show that too, correct? Because the camera was on at the time, wouldn't it? The camera would show that, wouldn't it?
You gotta have a chance to answer.
I am not sure. I know he went in front of her. I don't know if it was with the camera in front of it or not.
And you understood, as I understood your direct examination, that they spoke for just a few seconds, correct?
That was when when Clint Bearden went and asked her to leave, then Johnny asked her, my husband asked her to ask Clint, ask Tony.
I'm not asking you, listen to me. You know, is it possible that perhaps I'm not asking the right question, or you've just answered the question that's not being asked?
No, I think you're asking the right questions, but I do think you're trying to get me confused.
Okay, this is confusing. Tell me what's confusing about how long the conversation with Officer Wooten.
I do not know.
From your observation.
I do not know.
Is that a confusing question?
I don't know.
Okay, thank you. Was that a confusing question?
It's not confusing, I just don't know.
Thank you. Do you remember stating on direct examination that they spoke for just a few seconds? And that she was, and I quote, you were asked about throwing a temper tantrum.
Yes.
Okay. How long did that temper tantrum last?
10-15 minutes, even after they took her into the barn, she was still screaming.
At the time that she was first being removed, how long did that temper tantrum, we're not talking about...
It lasted. She didn't stop.
Okay. So I understand that she was violently shaking back and forth while she was still in the barn, seated, correct? Is that the temper tantrum you're talking about?
No, she wasn't. She was over the pay booth. I mean, the table there at that time.
That's the temper tantrum you're talking about?
No, I'm talking about the one she threw when they tried to get her to leave or put the camera down to quit being.
Let's talk about that. You didn't hear that conversation.
I didn't.
Did not hear that conversation. That's a yes or a no, please.
I didn't hear the conversation.
So
no.
Thank you. Because that's the only question that was asked. How did Ms. Tisdale get out of her chair? Do you know?
No, I really do not.
Did you see anybody pull her up out of her chair?
No.
Okay. How did she get from the front of the stage out of the barn? Did somebody take her out?
She didn't voluntarily go.
So someone had a hold of her, correct?
Yes.
And that someone was Officer Wooten, correct?
Yes.
And you heard her saying and yelling, I had permission. Kathy Burt told me I could.
Not at that time. No, she did not. At that time.
Did you hear her saying that as she was being taken back to, I guess, the area? And I'm sorry, the checkout counter?
Yes.
Okay. And she, at that particular point, was being dragged by Officer Wooten, correct?
She was resisting being asked or being taken out because she was fighting with him.
Sure. Did you hear her say, please identify yourself, who are you? Tell me
who you
are. I did
hear her say that.
Did you hear her say that multiple times?
She probably did. It was very embarrassing, the whole thing was, so I'll be honest. It was very embarrassing, so I did not really... I heard her ask him, but whether she kept on or what, I couldn't tell you.
You heard him ask her what?
I heard her ask him.
Okay, that's what I understood. She was physically removed, correct? she was taken to the, she was taken to the checkout counter, right?
Yes.
Now, as I understand it, at the checkout counter, were you in that location when Ms. Tisdale was?
Not to begin with, no.
Okay, and about how long after she was taken into the checkout counter area did you arrive?
Probably 10 minutes or so, because she kept screaming and hollering, and it was very distracting, very embarrassing. So I went in to see what was going on.
And you think that was about 10 minutes later?
Probably.
Okay. Did you hear her yelling for help?
I heard her hollering. I really don't know if she's hollering for help or not, but I did hear.
Did you hear her yelling, let go, you're hurting me?
I didn't. If she could have, but I didn't. It didn't sink in with me.
Okay. Did you, you know, after she was removed, did you stay in that location?
I only went in to try to soothe her, honestly. I really tried to soothe her.
All right. Well, when you went in and you had a conversation with her?
Well.
Or she said something to you, or did you say something? What did you say to her?
I went in and told her that she misrepresented herself, that she told me she was there down for the governor, and that she was not there for that reason.
Okay, and all right, when you made that statement to her, did she have both hands behind her back?
I don't know.
And handcuffs?
I don't know.
Was Deputy Wooten there?
I know he was there, and I don't know whether he was holding her hands or whether she was handcuffed.
All right, were you close enough to Deputy Wooten and to Ms. Tisdale, how close were you when you said that?
Very close.
Okay, less than a foot or about a foot away?
No, I was actually touching her, trying to soothe her.
Okay.
Because she was.
So that would have been in Deputy Wooten's hearing, right there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I assume that when you were asked about this previously, that conversation would have been included in what you told them before. Is that right? The Dawson County Sheriff's Office.
I didn't talk with them. I did talk with them, but they didn't. I didn't tell them that.
Okay. Well, you wanted to tell them everything that happened, right?
Well, they asked me questions. I answered their questions. They didn't ask me that.
Okay. And you didn't tell them?
I didn't volunteer it.
And who was the first person you told about that?
Well, my husband, all my family knew it. And people that, if there was anybody in there, they knew it.
And who was it? It was Clint Beard?
No.
Was your daughter or daughter-in-law in there?
My daughter was, yes.
Your daughter, she was in there.
And she knew it. She heard it.
Okay. So if she was asked about it, or she wanted to tell somebody about it, she would have told the authorities about it, right?
Not necessarily, not unless she was asked.
When was the first time you told either somebody from the sheriff's office or the district attorney's office about that?
I told them when we talked with them not long ago. Well, I had told others, but I don't know whether I told. I have not had an opportunity. Nobody had talked with me. I told them when I was asked to come talk, I told them.
Okay. And when was that?
Last week.
Okay. And did you talk with this young man right here?
I did.
I
again, I understand that, really it was the Republican Party that was kind of, running the show, right?
Right.
Did the Republican Party or anybody, like Clint, Mr. Beard, did anybody meet with you prior to the event to go over any potential rules or regulations or prohibitions or anything of that nature?
No.
I think, that's all I have.
You may, you may step in. You may call your next witness.